Greetings, this is Mr. Garwood with our continuing video series on Calculus Second Edition by Briggs, Cochran, and Gillette. This picks up where our previous video discussing the understanding of what a derivative is and how it arises from the idea of the slope of a tangent line. We're going to focus this video exclusively on the function f of x equals x squared, so traditional parabola centered at the origin. And our idea is that for some arbitrary point C, I'm not saying what C is, C could be any value of X, I want to find out, in general, what is the slope of the tangent line at C. And we started this discussion by discussing that, well, I could take a secant line, so I take any other value on this curve, and I draw a line between it and the one that I'm interested in, and as those two points get closer and closer and closer together, that secant line behaves a lot more like the tangent line that I'm interested in. So just a couple things I want to note before we get started. We're going to define the distance between x and c. So we'll just say x minus c, and we're going to call that delta x. And we're going to talk about the distance between the y coordinates, f of x and f of c. So delta y is f of x minus f of c. And that's where we find the slope of this green line, this secant line between two points, to start with. So if I'm evaluating, so we're going to say the slope of the tangent line equals the limit as x goes to c of the change in y over the change in x. So just to recap, we're looking at this change in x, this change in y over this change of x, and we are taking the limit as delta x goes to zero. And what we then can say is, well, we can just rewrite this as the limit as x goes to c of f of x minus f of c over x minus c. Now, we can then substitute in. We said that this function was f of x equals x squared, or y equals x squared. So f of x is simply x squared, f of c is simply c squared, and all of that is over x minus c. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of algebra, and I'm going to factor the top of this expression. And I know that because x squared minus c squared is the difference of perfect squares, that's not x squared goes to c, it's just x goes to c, I can factor that as x minus c times x plus c over x minus c. Now, I want to pause here because what we're going to see here in a moment is that I can cancel these two x minus c's because I have one on top and one on the bottom. And if we pretended that there was some function d of x, which is f of x minus f of c over x minus c, then d of c is undefined because that gives me zero in the denominator, and that's bad. But we're not talking about evaluating the function at x is c. What we're doing is we're asking, what is that function doing really close? And this goes back to doing the rational limits like we did in chapter 2. I'm not plugging in C. What I'm asking is what is the function doing when I'm really, really, really close to C? And we'll see that the left-hand limit and the right-hand limit, like we discussed, still converge to one value, even though that value is not defined. It is a point of discontinuity which is removable. If I could add one value in, we would be fine, and that's what this is evaluating. I am not dividing by zero, and I'm not canceling zero over zero, assuming it's one. What I'm doing is I'm saying these two around C, not at C, but very close to C, behave just like one, which means I can rewrite this as the limit as x goes to C of x plus c. Now, from here, I have no more domain restrictions. I have a polynomial, which means all I have to do is substitute for x, and I've got, that gives me c plus c, which is simply 2c. So, for any value of f of x equals x squared, if I want to know the slope of the tangent line at that point, I just double that point. So I could say, if c were 2, and I want to know what's the slope of the tangent line, what is the slope of the tangent line at x equals 2? Well, I would just say that it is 2 times 2, which is 4. So the slope at 2 is 4. And that's what that tells us. Now, there's one last thing I want to talk about before we conclude this video, and that's the idea of how do we write, instead of slope tangent line, like I was doing here, there is an official notation for the derivative. And it actually really arises from this statement right here. We said that the derivative is the limit as x approaches c of delta y over delta x. And how we write that, so if I have the limit as x goes to c of delta y over delta x, which is the slope of the tangent line, all these things mean the same thing, we write that as dy dx. And we talked about how delta is the Greek letter for d, and I'm just using a d. This is a notation introduced by Leibniz, one of the two men credited with inventing calculus, and I find it the most useful because if I can always think about the derivative in terms of it is the slope of the tangent line and the slope of anything is delta y over delta x, well, dy dx just reminds me this is just when delta x is very, very close to zero or zero, and this tells me how that works. So this is where this dy dx notation comes from. I hope you have found this video useful. Good luck in the semester.